Looks like we may have a little bit of drizzle on the lens there. Something kind of a blurry view of the downtown area. You can see the silhouette of it, and the camera's shaking. You'll notice that all day long. The wind's going to be blowing pretty good. 20, 30 miles per hour is what we're expecting throughout your Friday. Temperature right now is at 46. It's not that bad of a temperature until you factor in that wind that takes the wind chill, or feels like, back down into the upper 30s. Now, the numbers off to the north are in the upper 30s as well. Mid to upper 40s for Lamoni and Ottumwa as well. And the Viper display showing us those showers. As I mentioned, maybe a little bit of drizzle here in the metro, especially on the west side of town. And then you start to see the brighter greens and yellows. That's where you're getting a better chance of that rain actually becoming down at a light to medium pace. Panora seeing some of that as well. Carroll, back to the west of there, over towards Harlan, Atlantic east of there, and Creston, you can see northwest of there, and then back down southwest of Sheridan, west of Centerville. We're seeing those showers as well, probably just some sprinkles down towards Bedford. Here it is in motion for you. You can see it kind of slicing the state in half here. From the northeast part of the state, you're completely dry this morning, just some clouds. Southwest corner mainly wet for us. And this is all going to be spreading in. This is all rotating around an area of low pressure off to our south and west. Pretty easy to pick out there on this little loop. You can see that little swirl going on there. And the little tail you see coming from it, that's what caused the severe storms yesterday through parts of Oklahoma and Arkansas. That's going to give some severe storms down near the Gulf states a little bit later on today. But nothing like that for us, just rain showers. And this certainly catches the eye, doesn't it? Snow showers from the Canadian border back through north, south Dakota, into Nebraska, even northwest Kansas, and some of it may approach 6 inches or more, where you see these winter storm warnings off to our north and west. Notice none of those warnings across Iowa. I think the moisture should be leaving just in time for that cold air to arrive tomorrow morning. Here it is on Futurecast. Showers south and west of us this morning. They're going to continue to stream in late morning, early this afternoon. We're going to bring them farther off to the north as that moisture swings up in from Missouri. By this afternoon, still scattered showers around. I think it'll be off and on all day long. We'll get some breaks in that rain. And into the evening hours even, we're going to have a few showers around. And as we head towards Saturday morning, notice it all breaks up. Here's that slight chance for snow we've been watching all week as that cold air arrives. And it seems to be north of Highway 20. It's a rain-snow mix, so not looking for accumulating snowfall across the state. Looks like we'll see anywhere from a half inch to 3/4 inch of moisture out of this entire system. Here's what we're looking at. High temperatures today, mid to upper 40s north. We'll say lower to mid 50s into the southern half of the state. Not going to feel like that though with that breeze. That breeze is going to keep the wind chills in the 40s this afternoon, and unfortunately this evening. If we can get a game in without any rain showers, I think we could have some breaks, but it's going to be cold. 47 for a first pitch. Wind chills likely in the 30s tonight. Low temperatures are in the 30s. We'll keep that rain there through daybreak Saturday. Then we dry things out, mid-50s Saturday, upper 50s Sunday, slight chance of rain there. And we keep those slight chances of rain in for much of next week. And temperatures stay at or below normal for the next 8 days.
Okay, thank you.